Yo, what it do, y'all? It's your boy King Ed the Great coming at y'all with another video. So I want to talk about y'all about Real Compton City Gz and what was y'all reaction when y'all first heard it. Cause I'm gonna be real, I used to think Dr. Dre was possibly the hardest rapper in the game, man. Just by listening to those verses on the hardest nigga alive and the day the niggas took over, and what's the other one? The nigga got a gun, man. I used to think Dre was the hardest dude that ever grabs the microphone just by how he delivered his verses. He had me really convinced. Because I'm going to rob you Compton and blast you in Miami. That dude had me really convinced. 44 reasons come to mind. While a motherfucker brother is hard to find. He be walking on the streets and fucking with mine. Stupid punk can't fuck with the mastermind. See, I never took a step on a Compton block. Or LA without an AK ready to pop. Cause the punk motherfuckers in black and white. Ain't the only motherfuckers I got to fight. Good gracious. I usually used to think Dr. Dre, Ice Cube, Snoop Dogg, and was probably the scariest rappers alive in the game at that time, because you would see that even with Cube, Cube would never smile. Look at any picture from 91 to 97, Cube would never smile. But going back to the topic here, I used to date Dre was just this untouchable gangster rapper. Until Real Compton City Gz dropped. And that was my first exposure on record, on video. Because, see, Cube did a lot on No Vaseline when he exposed what was going on with the business side. Eazy took it another level here and exposed Dre on the personal side with the visual. This was the first Summer Jam Scream situation that happened. First of all, that beat was hard. Real Compton City G. Then he started rapping. Motherfucker Dre, motherfucker Snoop, motherfucker Death Row. No one, here comes my left bro. The way he delivered it was dope. And he had some hitters, man. Dre Day, me, Easy Pay Day. That was the chess move line right there. Because, yeah, Dre was talking ish about Easy, but Easy was making money off Dre. We didn't see that at the time because keep in mind that Death Row Machine was moving with Interscope. And it kind of undermined anything that Eazy was doing. So, then, it kind of undermined what Eazy was doing because they was running with Rolling Stone. They was rolling with MTV. They had Death Row had it on lock. And Eazy was looking like he was out of it. He was done. But he came back strong with this cut here. Then he brought Dreista, and Dreista broke down Snoop's whole gangster. What he's talking about, you ain't started banging since the peace treaty. I said, whoa. Then BG Knockout, he brought a nice little singy song flow there. I think that's where Daz got his from. His style, Daz kind of got that from BG Knockout later on. If you really listen. Then Eazy, he was the first to go in about the strong arm practices that was going on with Death Row. Gotta follow your sergeant's directions or get your ass popped with the Smith and Wesson. And it really went down like that. Like, if you won't really listen to what Suge was saying, according to what the people we heard, man, shoot, it was going down. So, the moral of the story is, Eazy came back strong, and that album put him back in the streets, the Real Compton City G's album, though, the 187 Dr. Dre album. They had signed that deal, that distribution deal with Relativity for $30 million. So, he was able to have the chops to get back into the game. And it was a dope diss. It was a real dope diss. Same with F for Dre Day. That was a real dope diss. And you could tell that the competitive nature was there. Shoot, that joint there made Eazy go back to the block. He went back to the block and shot that whole Real Compton City G's album. Single. But those were the good times, man. That was some great music involved. Rest in peace to Eazy-E. Unfortunately, we couldn't get that NWA reunion album. which was a sad case of what happened due to Eazy dying. But let me know what you guys think with that Real Compton City G's joint when you first heard it. Did you think it was the hardest ish out? Let me know. This is King Eric the Great signing out. Subscribe and hit that like button. And big salute to everybody that supported us through the way of 300. Holla at your boy.